Good morning, children. Welcome to our next class of botany. In today's class, we are going to study sex determination in plants. Now, about 95% of all flowering plants, they have only one type of individual. That is, it produces flowers with male organs, the stamens, and the female organs, the carpel. So, such plants, they are called as, sexually, they are called as monomorphic. Okay. So, here in the plant, they produce the male organ as well as the female organ in the same flower, then it is called as monomorphic. Whereas 6% of the flowering plants have two separate sexes and they are called as dimorphic. That is, the male plant produces the flowers with stamens and the female plant produces the flowers with carpels only. So, this sex determination in plants was first discovered by C.E. Allen in the year 1917. Now, sex determination is a complex process determined by genes. So, here also, the sex determination in the plants, they are controlled by the genes, the environment and the hormones. So, here sex determination in the plants, it is a complex process. So, here it is determined by the genes, determined by the environment as well as the hormones. Clear, children? So, sex determination in the plants is affected by three factors. One is the gene, next is the environment, and third one is the plant hormone secreted in it. Sex determination in Silene latifolia, that is Melandrium album, is of control by three distinct regions in a sex chromosome. So, in a sex chromosome, there are three distinct regions. If it is having the same as we studied, if it is a Y chromosome, will determine the male. If it is a X chromosome, it determines the femaleness. And X and Y show different segments. So, here in the X and Y chromosome, if we see, the Y chromosome has four segments. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the fourth segment is same in both X and Y chromosome. Okay, fourth segment is same in both X and Y chromosome. So, here the second, third segments, they determine the maleness in the plant. In the X chromosome, there are only two segments, the 5 and the 4 segments, and that determines the femaleness in the plant. Clear? So, here we have studied the sex determination in the plants is controlled. It's a complex process and it is controlled by the genes, the environment as well as the hormones. Next, you are going to study here about the sex determination in papaya plant. Researchers in Hawaii discovered sex chromosomes in papaya, Carica papaya. So, here in diploid condition it has 36 chromosomes. Papaya has 17 pair of autosomes and 1 pair of sex chromosomes. So, we know 17 pair of body chromosomes and 1 pair of sex chromosome. Male papaya plant have XY and female plant has XX. This is similar to the human being, we can say, unlike human sex chromosome. Papaya sex chromosomes look like autosomes and it is evolved from autosome. Now here, this papaya sex chromosome, it is said to be evolved from the body chromosomes, that is the autosomes. The sex chromosomes are functionally distinct because the Y chromosome carries the gene for male organ. Okay, the sex chromosome, Y chromosome, they carries the gene for male organ development, whereas the X bears the female organ development genes. In papaya, sex determination is controlled by three alleles. They are small m, M1 and M2 of a single gene. So, here we can say it is the multiple alleles which is determining the sex in the plant. So, there are three alleles for a single gene which is determining the sex in the plant. So, here if we see the genotype, they are having two small m, that is homozygous recessive condition is there, then it will restrict the maleness. It will not allow the male organs to develop. Okay, so here the plant is said to be a female plant. If M1 is present, capital M1, and recessive M is present, then it is a heterozygous condition and this will induce maleness and the plant is said to be male. Next, if the genotype is M2, capital M2, small m, again it is a heterozygous condition, it induces the development of both the sex organs. So here development of both the sex organs takes place, and this plant results in bisexual, and it is very rare. The fourth type of genotype, it can be either dominant M1 M1, okay, or dominant M2 M2, or heterozygous M1 M2. That is, whether it is homozygous or heterozygous dominant condition, it is inviable plant. It will not lead to the development of the male and the sex organs. As a result, this plant is said to be the sterile plant. So here we have studied in papaya plant, the total number of the diploid number of chromosomes is found to be 36. Out of this 36, out of the 17 pairs, that is haploid diploid condition, you can say 18 pair. Out of this 18 pair, 17 pair they are having the autosome, and one pair is the sex chromosome. Out of this, the Y is the male chromosomes, and they lead to the development of the male sex organs, as well as the Y, it leads to the development of the female sex organs. And in papaya plants, the character gene is controlled by three alleles, small m, capital M1 and capital M2. If recessive allele small m is present in homozygous condition, that will lead to the development of female plant. If in the heterozygous M1 and recessive m is present, then it will lead to the development of male plant. If heterozygous M2 and M is present, then both the sex organs will develop and lead to the development of bisexual plant. If it is in a homozygous or heterozygous, but dominant alleles are present there. So capital M alleles in both homozygous or heterozygous, what will happen? It will not lead to the development of the male sex organs, male or the female sex organs, and as a result will lead to the plant is said to be sterile. Next, you are going to study the sex determination in Staphylococcus. It is a bryophyte. Bryophyte, we can say, they are the plant which is having a thallus-like plant body. Here, where there is no root, no true root, leaf or stem is present there. Vascular tissues are also absent. So, sex determination was described in bryophyte Staphylococcus donnelly, which has a heteromorphic chromosomes. Okay, so there are morphologically different chromosomes are found in this bryophyte. The gametophyte is haploid. So gamete producing stages in haploid. So here also you can find in the life cycle they have the haplontic and diplontic stage. Okay, haploid condition is there and diploid condition. So gametophyte stage is haploid and it is heteromorphic. So here morphology of the plant is different. Okay, so male plant and female plant, they are different. That is what we call it as heteromorphic. The male gametophyte as well as the female gametophyte is a haploid organism. Here, chromosomes found in this plant is 8 chromosomes. So that is diploid number of chromosome is 8. The diploid sporophyte is always heterogametic. So here, in diploid condition, the sporophyte stage is diploid. And it is heterogametic. Heterogametic means two types of gametes are produced there. We have studied the female gamete here. It is called as the archegonium, and the male is called as the antheridium. The 7 autosomes, they are similar in both male and the female gametophyte. So as we studied, there is 8 pair of chromosomes are present. We have studied the haploid condition. It is having 8 chromosomes. Out of this 8, 7 chromosomes, they are the autosomes, which is similar both in male and the female. But the 8th chromosome of female is X, which is larger. Okay, in the female, the 8th X chromosome is larger than the autosomes. Whereas in the male, the 8th chromosome of male is Y, which is comparatively smaller than the autosomes. So here it is said that the 7 autosome chromosomes, they are similar both in male and female. The difference arises in the 8th chromosome. In the female, the 8th chromosome is an X chromosome, and it is larger in size than the other 7 chromosomes. Whereas in male, the 8th chromosome is a Y chromosome and it is smaller than the remaining 7 chromosomes. The sporophyte containing XY combination produces two types of meiospores. So sporophyte, yesterday it is a diploid condition. So here this XY combination, it will produce two types of meiospores, that is some with X and others with Y chromosomes. So here meiospores means that it will undergo the tetrad condition. Out of the four spores will be produced, four meiospores you can find, two will be of the X type and two will be of the Y chromosomes. The meiospores with X chromosome, that will produce the female gametophyte, and those with the Y chromosome will produce the male gametophyte. So this is what we have studied about the sex determination in Staphylococcus. So here we have studied Staphylococcus is a bryophyte. It has having heteromorphic chromosome. Now in the life cycle of Staphylococcus, we can say they have two type of life cycle, haplontic and diplontic. Gametophyte is haploid and the sporophyte is diploid state. Now here we have studied in the diploid sporophyte, they are having heterogametic, that is two types of gametes are produced there, archegonium and the anthridium, they produces the gametes. Now here we have studied in this Staphylococcus, there are seven types of chromosomes. There are eight type of chromosomes. Out of the eight, the seven chromosomes, they are the autosomes, which is similar in X and Y, and the eighth chromosome is different. Eighth chromosome in female, it is X chromosome, okay, and in the male, and it is larger in size, and in male, the eighth chromosome is called the Y chromosome, and it is smaller in size, okay. So here, by the combination of this X and Y, okay, now here it will undergo meiosis division and four tetrad spores are produced. These tetrad spores, what will happen? It will give rise to two spores with X chromosomes and the remaining two chromosomes with remaining two spores with Y chromosomes. Okay, so here this X chromosome will produce the female gametophyte and the Y chromosome will produce the male gametophyte. Next, you are going to study a sex determination in maize plant. The Z maize is an example of monoecious. Monoecious means the male and the female flowers are present in plant, but they are present separately, not in the same flower, but they are present separately in the same plant. So monoecious, Z maize is an example of a monoecious plant. Now there are two types of inflorescences found in this plant. You can see in the diagram, on the terminal we have the tassel. Okay, this tassel is said to be the male flower, and in the lateral side you can see the ear, or it is also called as scob. Okay, the side lateral development, that is called the female. Here in the tassel they have the stamens, here in the ear they have only the pistils. So here you can find there are two types of inflorescence. The terminal, that is on the tip, the inflorescence, they bear the staminate. Staminate florets means the male part that develops from the shoot apical meristem. So development of this tassel flower is from the shoot apical meristem. Okay, next, which is called as the tassel. The lateral inflorescence, which develops pistillate flowers. So lateral side we have the pistillate flowers, that is the female flowers, which is from the auxiliary bud, and it is called as the ear or the cob. So here remember the position of the male and the female flower. Male flower is terminal and it is called the tassel, and the female flower is present in the side or in the lateral, and it is called as the ear or the cob. Unisexuality in maize occurs through the selective abortion of stamens in ear florets and pistils in tassel florets. So here this unisexuality, as we have studied, here the male flower is separate and the female flower is separate. So the reason for that is the gene pairs, and there is the stamens in the male flower, the stamens will only develop and the pistils, they are aborted. Similarly, in the ear or the cob, that is the female flower, the pistils alone will develop and the stamens, they are aborted type, they are destroyed. A substitution of two single gene pairs, BA for barren plants and TS for tassel seeds, makes the difference between monoecious and dioecious maize plant. So here, the reason for this monoecious nature, that is the male and the female flower, they bond separately, is controlled by two genes. They are BA and TS. These are the two gene pairs which determines the differences between the monoecious and the dioecious. Dioecious means what? That is, the male flower is present in one plant and the female flower is present in another plant. But in monoecious, it is what? Both the male and the female plant, they are present in the same plant. So that difference in the plant is controlled by two genes, that is BA genes and TS gene. The allele for barren, when homozygous, makes the stalk staminate. So you first will see the stabular column, then you can understand here. Now this is the tabular column you can find as you have studied. The sex determination in the plant is controlled by this BA and TS genes. Now if this BA genes and the TS genes, recessive condition, lack silk on the stalk but transform the tassel to pistil. So here what is happening? Silk is present in where? In the female flower. So lacks silk on the stalk but transform tassel to pistil. Okay, so here rudimentary female, that is undeveloped female plant, is developed here. Okay, next is, if BA gene is recessive, okay, and TS is dominant, the plus sign represents, the subscript plus sign denotes the dominant character. So BA is recessive and TS gene is dominant. So what will happen? It lacks the silk. Silk is present where? In the female flower, and have tassel. So here what will happen? This dominant gene will suppress the female. As a result, what will happen? The male plant is developed there. So BA gene is recessive, TS is dominant, the plant will be a male plant. Now here both the dominant, double dominant alleles are present, BA, okay, BA is also dominant, TS gene is also dominant. So they have both tassel as well as the cob. So in the plant they are monoecious. So what will happen? The male flower will also develop, the female flower will also develop in the same plant. Next, if BA is dominant and TS is recessive, so BA dominant and TS recessive genes present there. So what will happen? It bears the cob. So what will happen? This BA will help in the development of the female flower and will suppress the development of the tassel flower. So here what will happen? The normal female flower will develop. So here you can see again here, if the double recessive alleles are present, both the alleles BA as well as TS, they are the recessive, then what will happen? It will develop into a rudimentary female. The female flower will not have a well developed female organ. Okay, or undeveloped female ovary will be present there, or undeveloped pistil will be present there. Next, if it is a BA, one allele is dominant and another one is recessive. BA is recessive, TS is dominant. What will happen? This TS will suppress the development of the silk in the female flower and it will lead to the development of male plant. If both are dominant, what will happen? They will lead to the development of both tassel and cob. Okay, both are dominant, this will lead to the development of both male flower as well as the female. Tassel is the male, cob is the female. So here this will lead to the development of monoecious plants. Next, BA is dominant, TS is recessive. One dominant and one recessive allele is present. So BA will develop the help in the development of the female flower and it will suppress the tassel flower. So what will happen? The sex of the plant will be normal female. So hope you have understood the sex determination in maize plant. So here we can understand this explanation given here. The allele for the barren plant BA, when homozygous, make the stalk staminate by eliminating silk and ear. So the BA, they are homozygous. Okay, so what will happen? It will lead to the removal of the female silk as well as the ears. Female flower development will not take place. The alleles for tassel seeds transform the tassel into a pistillate structure and produce no pollen. So here, when it is in the homozygous condition, The resulted sex expression based on the combination of these alleles, most of the mutation are known to defects in the gibberellin biosynthesis. As we have already studied, sex determination in the plant is controlled by genes, environment, as well as the plant hormone. So the plant hormone which is controlling the sex determination is what? It is the gibberellins. So gibberellins plays an important role in the suppression of the stamen in florets on the ears. So hope you have understood this topic, sex determination in plants. Thank you, children. We'll meet the next topic, mutation.